Welcome back. Did you know that our pets can have allergies just like us? And quite a few pets actually have this. Vet Blair is here to talk about dermatitis in dogs and two medications that can help control that problem. Plus, brought a sweet dog up for adoption. This is Bailey.
This is Bailey. She's about a one-year-old little Boston Terrier Chihuahua mix. Aww. She's just the sweetest, cutest little thing. Has the prettiest eyes.
Look at her. Beautiful eyes.
So she's full grown. She's not going to get any bigger than this. She's going to be, she's a great dog. She's going to be a fun dog to take to the park. And she's also going to be good in the house. So.
Tell me again her breed, Boston?
I think she's a Boston Terrier Chihuahua mix.
That is an interesting mix, but you know, this is a great dog, very calm.
Very calm.
She's been very calm the entire time.
Yes,
you are. I hope you find a home. SHERWOOD Animal Clinic is, or SHERWOOD Animal Shelter is where you need to call if you would like to take Bailey home. In the meantime, dermatitis is something, what is atopical?
Yeah, I call it atopic. It's itching from pollens, molds, dust, and dust mites. And 10% of dogs suffer from it.
Wow.
Yeah, they usually have itchy feet, get itchy ears and rears, their undercarriage itches, and there is a medication to help manage this problem.
Okay.
So first of all, you need to go to your vet because we need to make sure they don't have any parasites like Demodex or sarcoptic mange.
Okay.
And if there's a secondary bacterial or yeast infection, we need to treat that. We need to make sure they're not having like flea allergy or they're not allergic to their food, okay? So when we roll out those, we basically have atopic left.
Okay.
And the treatment is actually doing the hyposensitization therapy, which is like an intradermal skin test, and then we make a vial of serum up and they get allergens as an injection. And that is actually a treatment, but a lot of people either can't do that or it might not even work. So we've always historically reached for the steroids, either a shot of steroid or steroid pills. And the dogs, their side effects, they drink a lot, pee a lot, they're sometimes ravenously hungry. Long term, it's just not the way to go because it negatively affects the dog.
Okay.
So we have new medication. One is a pill called Apoquil, mm-hmm. and the other is an injection that's actually kind of like a vaccine called Cytopoint. And these both block the itch.
Oh, wow.
And they're just better for the dog. And I want everyone to know that if your dog is itchy, you need to talk to your vet about getting on these medications because it's really changed a lot of my patients' lives.
It's wonderful. Mm-hmm. You can just knock it out like that because you know this will drive the dog crazy.
Right.
All the time.
And it drives people crazy because mm-hmm. they can't sleep because the dog is scooting its rear or it's licking its paws.
Uh-huh.
And now, you know, if your dog has an obvious skin infection or an ear infection, the ears are stinky, we need to treat those infections because these medications, the Apoquil and the Cytopoint, do not treat infections. They just stop the itch, but they do it really well and they do it really fast.
Okay, call your vet, talk to them. Where can people come find you, Vet Blair?
They can see me at the Baineshout Veterinary Group. I'm in SHERWOOD and also Argenta.
Okay, go see her and call if you want to adopt this sweet dog. What a great dog.
She's
back after this. Good job.